What's going on, everyone? It's Made in Knowledge here, and we're gonna be looking at some new stuff that I got. Some very cool new stuff. Do we want to start proggy? Do we want to? Well, we'll just go in order of how the stack is. So a band that I've been getting into a lot recently, The Cure. This I picked up at one of the record stores about an hour and a half from where I live. This is The Cure Disintegration. It's got the song Fascination Street on it, which is automatically makes this album fantastic. I haven't listened to it much, so I don't know anything else. I mean, I know Pictures of You and Fascination Street, but that's about it. This is still a really, really good album. Next is the singles. This is Staring at the Sea, because they're standing on a beach, which is the cassette that I really want to try and find. This has got like a forest on it. I guess that's the only one I know. I know a forest because Stephen Wilson does a killer, killer cover of it. There. So I gotta listen to those more, and I'll tell you guys how they are when I listen to them more. Here's a band that not many people know about. This is a band called Psycho Motel. This is Adrian Smith from Iron Maiden. This is his band after he left Maiden, I believe. Let's look. So this actually has some cool people on it. This was 1997. This has Scott Gorham and Dave Murray on it. Psycho Motel, rock band. Okay. Yeah, so 1993, so it would have been right after. I don't know what else he would have done in between there, but after Fear of the Dark came out. But this is a very good album. It's a little less heavy than the first one, but it's still really good. I really enjoy this one. I have the first one. We'll go with some new releases. So this is a new release by Stephen Wilson. This is just a single. This is Eminent Sleaze, which I don't like the song, and I don't like Eminent Sleaze, and I don't like Infernal Green, but I really like Eyewitness because it sounds a little bit like The Cure. Oh, yeah, my case is a little broken. That's what happens when you get stuff imported with no insurance, no nothing from the UK. Oh, well. I guess if I want to keep it, then I don't care, but if I want to sell it, then I just got to sell it for less than I would normally. And next, we have an album that came out a week and a day ago, jeez, because I got this 2 days ago, this CD. This is Fate's Warning, Long Day, Good Night. This is the Digibook version. It's got the booklet in it, and then the CD, of course. So, Destination Onward is awesome. Alone We Walk is cool. Under the Sun's awesome. Scars. The Way Home. Begin Again. When Snow Falls. Liar. Glass of Diamonds. The whole album is great. There's not really a bad song on this one. There's a couple mellow ones. So, like, When Snow Falls, Under the Sun, Now Comes the Rain. Those are a little bit mellower. Still a Fate's Warning album. Still fantastic. Definitely go recommend getting it. And next we have a Blu-ray. This is Anesthetized. So this is the Blu-ray DVD sells. Oh, I guess the Blu-ray is in my DVD player. Let me grab it. Because it's cool. But this I bought it because it has the extra live films. So Way Out of Here, My Ashes, Wedding Nails, Strip the Soul, /Dot 3, and No Recurring. Which, when I got it, I thought it was more live things, but it's not. It's what they would play in the back. It's what they would play on the screen when the song was playing. Come on. I want my disc. There we go. Just so I can show you guys the artwork on the disc. But there. So, DVD and Blu-ray. Very, very cool. But again, it's got the whole Anesthetized show, minus Prodigal. I believe that's the only song that's missing. So they play the whole of Fear of a Blank Planet, Let's see. And that's the size. I just want to look at the track listing. This is why I have a computer up here. So I can look at things. Wikipedia. So yeah, they do the whole of Fear of a Blank Planet. So yeah, Prodigal is missing right after Sleep Together, which I would have taken it out anyways. I don't really like that song that much. But it's cool, they do like Drown With Me, which wasn't available until the In Absentia reissue. Stuff like Half Light, they play a lot from, or I guess not a lot, just two or three, from Signify, Sever, Dark Matter, Sleep and No Dreaming, Sever, Dark Matter, yeah, they do Drown With Me, Cheating the Polygraph, What Happens Now, Normal, Wedding Now, Strip the Soul, Dot 3, and then Halo at the End. Yeah, Half-Light, which is only on, I think it's only on the vinyl issue of Deadweight. But yeah, this is one that is starting to sell for stupid money, so I don't think I'm gonna hang on to this one. I might hang on to it for a little while, but I thought that all this stuff was more live shows, because I wanted to see No Recurring live. But it's not. It's just what they would play in the background. Those are the CDs and DVDs and all that hokey pokey. So let's move on to the vinyl. So this is, I did get the New Fates Warning album on vinyl. This is the yellow orange, or the red yellow orange splatter vinyl. I have not taken the shrink wrap off because I don't really care about the gatefold, and I wasn't gonna listen to it anyways on vinyl, but the CD didn't come in enough time. So there's the vinyl. Very, very cool. I don't think it comes with any sort of insert. Oh yes, it does. Lyrics, and then this is cool. I just noticed that. So I didn't know that this was in there. So that's very, very cool. But yeah, I haven't taken the shrink wrap off because it's a gatefold, and I don't really need to see what the inside looks like, because I will probably never play this again on vinyl since I have the CD. But yeah, like I said, there's a lot of good tracks on this. So if you have not picked this album up and you're a Fates Warning fan, go get it like right now. Go on Amazon right now and order it. yeah. It's not as heavy as There Is a Flight, or what's the other one? Darkness in a Different Light, but it's still really good. It's got a couple mellow songs, but it's still heavy. Let's do more cool colored vinyl. I don't know if I showed this one in the last video, but this is Chon. So this is a math rock band from like the early or mid 2000s. I think they're mid 2000s. Because I believe this was their first album. So this is called Grow. John. Oh, 2008. So when did the first... Was this? Yeah, so this was the first real album that came out in 2015. There are two albums before it. Two EPs. And there's a demo. Oh, I gotta look for that now. I didn't know that. Thanks, Wiki. But this was a Record Store Day release. It comes in one of these sticky sleeves. Which is kind of cool. There's no writing on it, which I like. I like that they don't add all the extra bits. There's the gatefold. There's a booklet that comes with it. This booklet is so cool. It's got so much imagery in it. But what I noticed is, yeah, the track listing over there is wrong. It's missing two songs. Missing the last two for credits and stuff. But yeah, more artwork and then the last page. But enough of the booklet. You came to see the vinyl. So here's the sleeve. And then what is this? What does the vinyl look like? Oh yes, the vinyl looks very, very pretty. Look at that. half yellow, half clear with green and blue splatter. Like that's just cool. I did play this a couple times because I don't have it on CD and I don't think they did a CD release of it. But I am gonna have to go find those demos from 2008 because I bet those are very, very different. But yeah, Chun Gro. This is the Record Store Day release. This is probably the cheapest release you're gonna find, and it's still gonna run you like $40. It's insanely expensive. Well, for a vinyl record, I think I paid $25 for it. Maybe I paid $30. I don't know. Yeah, I'm gonna look at the Discogs later. Chun. Let's just look. But yeah, so this, yeah, what is it? Splash is really cool. Moon is cool. Perfect Pillow, Story, Suda, or Sude, Book, not Echo, but the whole album is really, really good. I would definitely recommend listening to this. Thank you, Dak, for blowing leaves outside my window. We're gonna get a little older. This is Frank Zappa's Uncle Meat, which I haven't listened to. So got the sticker with it. It doesn't come with the book, I don't believe. Does it? No, it does not come with the book. But this is on Bizarre. So the Blue Bizarre label. But like I said, I haven't listened to it. I don't know anything about this album other than it's Frank Zappa. There's the gatefold. So, I will let you know when and if I listen to this and what I think of it. Call back in the sleeve. Yeah, it's got Zappa on it. I guess that's all I know. Oh, Lowell George. He's on this one too. It's from Little Pete. Yeah, I think I'll save those for a separate video because it's a trio of things that I would probably talk more in depth about. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you did enjoy, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, turn on bell notifications, and we just did 100 subscribers, so that's cool. I might do a giveaway. I don't know. It's always fun to do a giveaway. I'll probably do an Amazon gift card or something because it's easy. I can just buy it online and send it to you. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. And I hope to see you in the next video. Sayonara.